Okay, I am Deitxa Tadi from Techniker. I am going to talk about IoT and robotic solutions for smart agriculture. I work in Techniker, that is a technological center, and our mission is technology transfer. I am going to talk about two European projects. The first one is Internet of Food and Farm 2020. This is a quite big project. It's about 30 million euros, and it is finishing now in this year, and it has five trials, arable, fruits, vegetable, meat, and dairy, and each trial has three or four use cases. We are working in the meat trial, and it has three use cases, pig farm management, poultry chain management, and meat transparency and traceability. We lead the poultry chain management, and it's, the aim of this project is to improve poultry welfare and increase the meat quality. This covers the full chains, as you can see in the diagram, from the farm production and to the processing industry. And in the left of the image, you can see the partners that are working in this use case. At farm level, we manage poultry growth and monitor animal welfare. We have an environmental sensor network that measure temperature, humidity, luminosity, CO2, and ammonia. And we have also scales for animal weighting and silos weighting to check the quantity that animals are eating. At the logistics, it's important to monitor both the transport in the truck of the poultry and also the loading of the poultry in the trucks. As you can see in the image, this is a very manual task and is paid when the work is finished. So usually the person in charge of this work doesn't do it very in a delicate way. So we use some smart bands to monitor the movements of when the poultry is loaded, and we can correlate those movements with the injuries or bruises in the poultry. We are monitoring three poultry farms, two trucks with five sensors and five people for poultry loading. Monitoring all these paths, we can improve poultry welfare and increase meat quality. And this has two impacts at two levels. One at the level of the welfare, because there are death reduction in production, death reduction in transport, improve animal welfare, and this improvement makes that we can decrease the use of antibiotics. That's very important both for the animals and also for when we for us when we eat this meat. And those impacts means another impact in the profit, economical impact, because we get a more uniform weight and size. So when the meat is cut with automatic cutting machines, we take the most of the meat from its birth. We can have more class A birds. That means that we can sell the bird as a whole, and we don't have to cut it. That reduces the price of the product, and also it means more sustainability, because there is less waste of feed. And the other project that I want to talk about is the Green Patrol project, that is about greenhouses. It's an autonomous robot, Biocall, that detect, identify, and treat pests in tomato greenhouses. You can see here the prototype of the robot in a tomato greenhouse. And this is one of the first projects that use Galileo for indoor positioning. This global satellite navigation system enables better accuracy of positioning inside the greenhouse. For the detection and identification of the pest, we use deep learning. The process for this learning is shown in this diagram. First, we have to generate a data set. Then there is the data set labeling that is quite a hard work. And for having more images and more information, we use a data set augmentation that increase the amount of images and provide images with different features like noise or blur or things like that. And then there is the selection of architecture and hyperparameters. After that, there is the training, and finally we use most of the images for the training, and we take some of these images, a different quantity of images for the evaluation of the software. This labeled data set of the tomato pest are free, available to the scientific community. This is something that this project has give to the scientific community because it's a quite a hard work. Here you can see in the image the detection of the eggs in the initial state in the leaf of the tomato plant, but we can also detect the insect, the bugs, as you can see in the left image, and also the damage that this pest can produce in the leaf, that as you can see on the image on the right. For this robot has to have different objectives like localization, autonomous navigation, inspection task, and treatment mission. So for all these things, we need to integrate quite a lot of elements in the platform, like a mobile platform, safety laser scanners, robot arm, 3D laser scanners, emergency stop buttons, vision cameras, the Galileo receiver, and spraying system for spraying a pesticide when it's needed or a pest is detected. And finally, one important part of the system is the user interface, where you can see all the data collected from the robot. For example, here you can see the scouting plan that is shown in the image on the left, where the critical areas and are pointed in a blue square, where the robot has to monitor with more carefully. And on the right image, you can see the scouting results, where you can see in green the areas that are okay, and in red the areas that pest has been detected and identified. So the next step that the robot has to do is come back there and apply the pesticide for controlling this pest. And that's it.